Dostoevsky's Crime and Punishment, first published during 1866 in 12 monthly installments and later published in a single volume, remains the most widely known Russian novel, as well as one of the greatest achievements in world literature. In Russian, the title of the book connotes a stepping across, which, as we'll see, is a recurring theme throughout the novel. The book is disguised as a murder mystery, in which the reader knows from the start who has committed the crime. This in-depth exploration of the psychology of a criminal is at the heart of the novel, delving deeply into psychological punishment. The main themes include alienation, suffering, morality, faith, or the God-man, Jesus Christ, and the extraordinary man, or the man-god, as well as the philosophical themes of nihilism and utilitarianism. The protagonist, Raskolnikov, derives his name from schismatic. One of his most fundamental character traits is his alienation from society. He is a materialistic rationalist, as well as an atheist and nihilist, taken by the idea that God is dead. He is a sickly and impoverished, but handsome and intelligent, former law student unable to pay for his studies. Dostoevsky wanted to set up a character who had every reason to commit murder. The book focuses on Raskolnikov's mental anguish and moral dilemmas. His mother, Pulcheria, is deeply devoted to him, willing to sacrifice everything so that he might be successful. Dunya is his sister, who is as intelligent and good-looking as him, but is his exact opposite, self-sacrificing, kind, and compassionate. Marmeladov is an alcoholic public official whom Raskolnikov meets at a tavern. He is fully aware that his drinking is ruining himself and his family, but he is unable to stop. His wife is sickly and their daughter, Sonia, has been forced into prostitution to support the family, which includes her three siblings. Sonia shares a strong religious faith. Raskolnikov's former college friend, Rasumikhin, is the voice of reason. A central motif of the novel is the poverty-stricken St. Petersburg. Almost every character is desperately poor, as well as the constant drunkenness. Dostoevsky worked on a novel titled The Drunkards, which ultimately became Crime and Punishment. It starts off early with Raskolnikov receiving a letter from his mother informing him that his sister is engaged to be married to a government official named Luzhin, a rich man who only cares about his social appearance and who looks for an attractive wife to practically worship him. Dunya's intent is to help her brother out financially. Raskolnikov, of course, is very much against this. Raskolnikov goes to a tavern where he eavesdrops on a conversation in which a student claimed that the world would be better off if the wealthy pawnbroker Aliona were dead and the money were used to perform great deeds for society. Aliona is a wicked old woman who takes advantage of everyone while physically and emotionally abusing her innocent half-sister, Lizaveta, who is mentally challenged. Throughout the novel, Raskolnikov is faced with a moral dilemma between good and evil. He distinguishes between ordinary and extraordinary people, such as Napoleon. He sees himself as a sort of extraordinary man. He writes an article where he mentions a new morality and how extraordinary men are allowed to transgress accepted moral standards for the common good with a clean conscience. Raskolnikov goes to Aliona's apartment and murders her with an axe. While looking for her money and goods, Lizaveta walks in. Shocked, Raskolnikov kills her as well. He barely escapes from the apartment without being seen, then returns to his garret and collapses. After the murder, Raskolnikov claims that a louse has been removed from society. However, the guilt that torments his conscience after the murder suggests that he's not extraordinary after all. His conscience is rooted in the old morality based in religion, mentally unbalancing him. In a way, along with the murder, he had also killed a part of himself. Dostoevsky seems to suggest that actual imprisonment and punishment is much better than the stress and anxiety of trying to avoid punishment. One must eventually confess or go mad. The next day, the police summon Raskolnikov, but it seems unrelated to the murders. However, he faints and they start suspecting him. He goes on to hide the goods he stole from the pawnbroker under a stone. He visits his friend Rasumikhin, but quickly escapes and returns to his small room, refusing his offer of a job. He falls into a nightmare-ridden sleep with fever and delirium for several days. So Zimov, a doctor, checks up on him, and he's also visited by a detective, whom he nearly confesses to. Raskolnikov finds out that Marmeladov has been run over and is deeply injured. He carries him back to his apartment where he dies. He gives the money he has left to Sonia and returns to his garret, where he faints upon discovering that his sister and mother are there waiting for him. He becomes irritated by them and commands his sister to break her engagement with Luzhin. Rasumikhin starts to fall for Dunya. Next, Raskolnikov visits the magistrate in charge of the murder investigation, Porfiry Petrovich, who is Raskolnikov's primary antagonist, and though he only appears occasionally in the novel, his presence is constantly felt. Raskolnikov thinks that he is suspecting him of the crime. While returning to his garret, a mysterious man calls him a murderer in the street, terrifying him. After waking up from nightmares, he finds a stranger in the room, Svidrigailov, one of the most enigmatic characters of the novel, who, like Raskolnikov, also thinks he's an extraordinary man and has no faith in God. He is Dunya's former employer and is in love with her. He offers a large sum of money for Dunya, but Raskolnikov is suspicious. Raskolnikov and his family uncover a lie about Luzhin spreading false rumors to Dunya. She breaks off her engagement. However, Raskolnikov ruins the mood by telling his family that he does not want to see them anymore. His friend chases him and they stop face to face. Rasumikhin then realizes, without a word being spoken, that Raskolnikov is guilty of the murders. Raskolnikov goes to the apartment of Sonia, who reads him the story of the raising of Lazarus from the Bible, promising a new life through faith. The following morning, he visits Porfiry, who plays psychological games with him. At the height of the tension, a workman who is being held under suspicion for the murders bursts into the room and confesses to the murders. On the way to Marmeladov's funeral, Raskolnikov meets the mysterious man who called him a murderer, and learns that the man knows very little about the case. After a disastrous and conflictive memorial dinner, Raskolnikov goes to Sonia's room and confesses to her. She tries to convince him to confess to the authorities. Sonia's consumptive mother soon dies after a mental breakdown. Svidrigailov, who had been overhearing Raskolnikov's conversations with Sonia, reveals to him that he knows he is the murderer. He is also approached by Porfiry, who urges him to confess, although he has no evidence to arrest him. Svidrigailov manages to bring Dunya to his room, where he threatens to rape her if she refuses to marry him. She fires several shots at him, but is unable to commit murder, unlike Raskolnikov. After Svidrigailov sees how strongly she dislikes him, and having already lost his sense of the extraordinary man, his faith and his love, he has nothing left. The next morning, he commits suicide. Raskolnikov tells his family that he's planning to confess. He goes to Sonia, who gives him a cross to wear. On the way to the police station, Raskolnikov stops in a marketplace and kisses the ground. He confesses. In the much-discussed epilogue, Raskolnikov is sent to prison in Siberia only for 8 years, instead of receiving a death sentence. Sonia has moved to the town outside the prison, and she visits him regularly. After his arrest, his mother became delirious and died. Rasumikhin and Dunya were married. For a short while, Raskolnikov remains convinced that his crime was an error and not a sin, stating that he just wasn't extraordinary enough. After a serious illness, he dreams of an infectious disease sweeping the country, causing its victims to believe themselves to be the sole possessors of truth. People start fighting each other, causing the complete breakdown of society. This may be an allegory for the spread of dangerous ideas that Dostoevsky had witnessed: nihilism and materialism, with a lack of belief in Russian orthodoxy. Towards the very end, Raskolnikov realizes that he truly loves Sonia, and is thrown to her feet by the grace of God. breaking through the wall of alienation, nihilism, and self-centeredness that has separated him from society. He expresses remorse for his crime and begins a new story of the gradual renewal of man.